Good evening. Continuation with the previous session. Today in this session, we'll be learning what is interactive mode, what is script mode, operands, operators, and string operations, and type conversion. Now, when I say interactive mode, the interpreter executes and displays the result. As I told you before, Python is a great calculator. Now let us see. For example, if I say 4 plus 3, immediately what it gives? It gives me 7. The way I ask the question, immediately the Python prompt will answer to me. So it is interactive. Immediately I'll be getting the response. For example, if I say 4 star 2, I'll be getting 8. If I say 23 divided by 4, I'm getting answer immediately. So this is called interactive mode. The other mode of execution is script mode. Let us see what is script mode. For this, I need to open a new file where I'm going to type something here. Here, what I'm going to do is I'll type something. I have written something here. Now, what I want to do is I'll run this program. Before I run, I need to save it. So it will ask you to save. So let me save it as some simple name. Give it as a name. My first program. First.py. If my code contains more than 4 to 5 lines, it is always good to open a new file and write my code there. So it is like this. You can see the answer. We got 437.5. Now we are in interactive mode. Now let us see what is operators and operands. Operands and operators, whatever we have mentioned here, 4 and 3 are called operands, and plus, star, division operator, all these are operators. Now, these are special symbols that represent computations. Now, all we have seen is here, that they do some or the other computation. Now, Python also supports this modulus sign. When I say modulus, if I say 5, it gives me the remainder. So division always gives you the decimal points along with the decimal point. Now, if I want only quotient, then I can use double slash and say 5. So I can get the quotient value. Now in Python, when I said 4 plus 3, we got 7. Suppose in place of 4, if I say this plus 3. So what would be the answer? Since it is a string, we get 4, 3. Plus acts here as concatenation. So here concatenation means joining the strings when you apply plus to either integer or floating point numbers. As I told you earlier, Python is a dynamically typed language, which means declaration of variable is not necessary. But as a user, I should know what exactly Python understands, whatever value we store, isn't it? So in Python, we have type function to know what type a particular variable holds. Now say, for example, if I say a is equal to 10. Now when I type a, it immediately responds saying 10. That means in variable a, we have value 10. Now what type it is, just if we type here and say a, See, what does it give? It gives class int. Here in Python, now variable a acts like a object. So that's why it is giving you class and int. It is of integer type. So this object and class we will delete later. Now as of now we will see. Now I'll try to store f is equal to 23.5. Now again f, if you say it is holding 23.5. Now again if you want to see what type of variable it is, I'll just say f and c. So it is having float, right? Now suppose when we include integer, now I need to have some sort of calculation. Say for example, I'll say a plus f, already I have, right? And I'll try to store it in some variable. So I'll say b equal to a plus f. Now I'll try to see b. Now if you observe here, what is a? A is an integer. And what is f? F is a floating point number. Now what is happening here? The result is finally a floating point number only, right? So what happens in Python? Whenever we include integer and floating point in an expression, integer is implicitly converted to a float, because float takes more memory space to store and therefore it overrides int. Suppose if you do not want that to happen, then you need to explicitly typecast by built-in function int and float. Say for example, now I don't want 33.5. Now what I'll do, b equal to a, I will retain as it is. Now f was float, isn't it? So I will typecast it using int function and say f. Now f will be converted or typecast to integer. Now what happens is the result, if you see the result, what will be the result? Only 33. So this is how you are going. This is called type conversion in Python. Now let us see what is user input. Say suppose you want to take a value from the user via keyboard. So Python provides built-in function called input and gets input from the keyboard. Now let us see how it is. Inp equal to, I'll say input. So input is a function. The moment I say inp equal to input and say enter, this input function expects the user to type something. So I'll type, how are you? Enter. Now what is stored in INP? Let us see. How are you? Whatever I have typed, that is stored in INP variable. Now input function by default, it will return string. Okay. Now, as in C, we have scanf statements, right? So before we give an input value, we will prompt the user, right? What exactly he wants to do. So that is exactly we are doing here. How are you? Now, instead of this, if I say inp equal to input and just say within this parenthesis, I'll just ask, how are you? Now, if I enter, it is asking me question and now I need to answer. I'll say, I am fine. Now what is stored in INP? INP, sorry. I am fine is stored in INP, right? Now, suppose if I ask, what is your age? What happens? Age cannot be string, isn't it? So it should be integer. So I'll just again rewrite this. INP equal to input. Now I'll ask, what's your age? So what should be my reply? I'll say 23. Now in INP, what is there? Actually, it should be 23 integer, but it is stored as a string. If you want to check what we can do, I can check with type INP. It is a string. So what I should do while giving this input alone, I can typecast it. So what I'll be doing? So here, I'll make it as int. Now I can say 23. If you type INP and see, it is integer. Now, what if I want to give multiple inputs like how we use in C language? So as many input values we can give in C, right? Similarly, can we give even in Python? Yes, we can give. So in LHS, you have two variables, X and Y, at the same time, input, I'll be giving, enter two values. Now, I need to use a string method called split. Since we know input function will return string, isn't it? So we can make use of string method called split. Now if you see, it will ask you enter two values. I'm going to enter two values. In X, what is stored? 2 is stored. And in Y, it is stored 3. But here if you see, when I try to give what 2 and enter. So here I cannot give in different line. I'm supposed to give and the values whatever I have assigned, it could be 2 values or 3 values. I should enter it in the same line. Because the moment I enter the enter key, even enter key also takes as one character. So it does not allow. We are supposed to enter in the same line. So that's why we got error here. The moment we entered the key, we got a error. Now if you observe here, 2 and 3 are not integers, they are strings. Now how do I convert it into a string? So I cannot use, earlier how I used, I can't use here int here, int, and I'll get error if I do this. Okay, I'm not supposed to do this. I'll be getting error. Right? So we have one more function called map. One other way of giving multiple input values is map. I need to use map function where I'll be passing two parameters. That is, one is integer. The other one is input. Now I'll give same, enter. Enter two values. And then I'll give dot split. Yeah, now if you see 2, 3. Now you see X has integer value and Y has integer value. So these are the different ways of giving multiple inputs through keyboard. Okay, thank you.